Hello everyone, welcome to ARPIT program of LIES professionals developed by IIT Delhi. Today my lesson is going to be on marketing of library products and services. I am a fellow in the Knowledge Resource Center and I am in Terry since 2009. I have also served some of the leading organization in the country such as University of Delhi. Today in this topic, I am going to cover these components like marketing, marketing objectives, marketing mix, that is 4 P's to 7 P's, the details of the 4 P, that is marketing mix, the customers, users, stakeholders, information marketplace and some of the marketing research areas. Now, key points of marketing, it is a business process, meeting the customer requirements, meets the organization's objectives, an exchange process applies to ideas, goods and services. So, basically marketing is a management aspect which is started by Professor Philip Kotler. Now, as far as the marketing objective, the SMART concept is concerned, it has to be specific or focused, giving details of the products and the market segments, the measurable or quantifiable, the achievable with the context and resources which are available, the relevancy contribute to the organizational success and align with the corporate objectives, and another is the timeliness, which is very important when you provide a service to your customers or to your stakeholders. Now, why library marketing? Why we are talking about this particular subject in the library information science context? The number one is funds problem. You have to build the image of the library. You have to do something proactive. You have to do the changing scenario of the library and information center. There is an optimum utilization of resources is required, and there is a proactive service to the users. So there is a paradigm shift is taking place from a conventional library system to the modern library system, and that is what we basically called as a transformation today. Now, entire this library marketing, it is not a new concept. In fact, the library marketing started well before actually in the marketing subject came into being. This is the picture of a lady, Greta Renbach. She is a very renowned person in the field of marketing library services. The history of marketing library begins long before the concept was born in 1997. Now, she wrote an article which was published in 1897, which was on railroad traveling libraries. It means in the rail, she created libraries which are going to provide the service of the to the passengers who are traveling by the train. Now, the same thing, Elstons also came out a very interesting book called Books in a Box. Well, Lucy Stans, she talks about the established 100 of traveling libraries in Wisconsin from 1895 to 1914. And very interestingly, you can understand the people who are traveling in the train for long, long hours, they can, you know, get the books issued there and they can, you know, enhance their knowledge. That kind of library came up. There was an article, I mean, if you come across this article, please read it. It's a very, very interesting article. Now, there is a lot of definition of the classical concept of marketing. John McCarthy, in 1957, he talked about the customer-oriented and the integration system. Philip Kotler and Sidney Levi, in 1969, very clearly they defined it is not selling, it is not promotion, but service which adds value. Philip Kotler, again, that's why we call Philip Kotler as the father of the marketing. Philip Kotler and Zaltman in 1971 talked about social marketing. Philip Kotler, once again, along with Alan Anderson, talked about in 1996, talked about create, build and maintain the beneficial exchange relationship with the target audiences for the purpose of satisfying individuals and organizational objectives. Theodore Levitt in 1960 talked about a marketing myopia, which is an extremely important article. I would urge that each one of you should read this article. He makes a complete distinction between a selling and a marketing. You know, when you talk about a selling, it means you are providing a service to XYZ user or a customer against a price. There is a price tag attached to it. You are selling, that there is a commerce is taking place. Whereas this marketing is bringing the awareness, creating a brand. Well, a lot of things we will discuss in subsequent slides, where you are talking, you are increasing the outreach of the entire thing. Product orientation, customer orientation, he has talked about, Theodore Levitt in 1960, is a very interesting article. Jerome McCarthy talked about 1960, the four P's of marketing, which is, once again, it is a very, very important aspect in it. Users, and in current context, is the next generation, net, that is the internet generation. We call it a generation Y or millennials. Don Tapscott in 1998 talked about that how the computer literacy is bringing a sea change in the entire users community. Talgan and Martin, he talked about how, I mean, the people who were born in the late 70s, how they are IT savvy and what is their change is taking place. Howe and Strauss in 1992, he talked about, he gave a complete, you know, he talked about millennial, that is a from 1982 onwards to 2000 as the rebirth of the new type of consumers and customers which is there. But there were a lot of other articles also, like on information seeking, the library is not the only source of information and not all information needs are academic. Well, this is a complete outline structures, the who is the net generation, the characteristics. He is a tech savvy, his thinking styles is different, his learning style is different, and his behavior, the lifestyle is different. When you, I mean, each one of them, when you talk about tech savvy, I mean, today he is connected to internet, email, laptop, MP3 players, podcasting, personal blog. When he's thinking about a style, he's non-linear, he's graphic oriented, he's randomly. And when you're talking about the learning styles, he's a visual learner. He's just self-explanatory. He can learn himself. That's a very important thing. And the behavior lifestyle is, he's a positive thinker, he's a multitasker, he's a goal achiever, he's a motivator. So there is a radical change is taking place as far as the next generation is concerned with context to the library marketing. Now, there are two different viewpoints. A librarian's viewpoint, where you have the books, videos, reserves, e-journals, library, I mean articles, databases. Whereas in the users, when you look at it, is more into Google, course websites, library website, friends, textbooks and all. So there is a complete different view. So you need to understand the perspective of the, as a librarian or as a user. You have to differentiate that. There is a market. Library uses has been increasing and not decreasing. The ease of acquiring information has created millions of information consumers with university students, the most discerning and the demanding of them. They have, I mean, they come well prepared when they come to the library. Marketing of library services. Marketing, the key to connect to the users. They have a way of thinking. Every interaction, every connections. Users don't really know what we can offer. Switching from collection-centric to user-centric through access and services. Understanding who are the users. Focusing on their specific needs and their expectations. So, marketing library services also become the person who reaches out to users and bring them the answers what they are looking for. Their delivery need information and also provide services of which they were unaware. In fact, Eric Wainwright, there is a very interesting 2004, there was a very interesting article he has written on People, Networks, Books, New Strategies for University Academic Information and Service Delivery. I would urge everybody should go through it. He says that, it is a quotation taken, the best services give more than the customer expectation through stimulation of the unexpected learning that comes through serendipity and unplanned beneficial interaction with services, people and resources. Please remember, I am using here three very important components: services, people and resources. Now, marketing library services in the physical context is creating the flexible environment in the library, like comfortable browsing seats, built-in cafe. Then you can late study areas, various spaces for individuals with different learning styles, the group study rooms, the quiet study place, computer zones, teaching space, etc., and the information commons. These are a couple of images I have taken from the some of the best libraries which are there. You see the kind of attraction which is created here with the kind of, you know, sitting places, the, you know, the color combinations. I mean, you know, you make it a happening place, make it a place for the users to get attracted. They will, more and more people will come and visit, give them a comfortability, give them what they are looking for. So if you create such kind of an ambience plays a very, very important role as far as a library marketing is concerned. Now, marketing library services in this ICT world, in the virtual context, creating a library website with visual graphics, generating individual portal web page listing relevant resources, developing online game or multimedia tutorials, positioning the librarians as players in teaching. They, like, for example, incorporate the library resources in the course management system. So librarians and the library resources are integral part of the courses. Then, you know, more you need to be a part of the, when the entire pedagogy of the course structures are developed or course outlines develops, so library professional should be a part of it. And then email reference services and live reference assistance in real time. Then, you know, then you can develop a My Library portal or a My Library space, a MySpace, like for example in Orkut and all it is there. Like web blogs, wikis, and then you have RSS feeds and podcasting. Then offering workshops directly related to their particular topic, attending departments, faculty, meetings, and always have new and relevant information for them. Provide convenient services to the users. And the other thing is, we need to create library newsletter, advertising in college websites, database of the month, then involvement in college public relations activities and all. So some of these components I would be dealing in detail when I will coming in my subsequent slides. Our father of library information science, Ranganathan, does marketing. You will be all surprised to know how I have related this. Library resources are for use. If a resource is not being used, it should be either eliminated or it should be marketed properly. Every customer, his or her library resources. It is not enough to make customers happy. We must delight them. There is a difference between customers' happiness and the delightness. So please try to understand. It's pleasing them. Do more than they expect. Every library resource, its customer. That means how you are positioning it, how you branding it, and save the time of the customer. The librarian's mantra: better, cheaper, and faster services. Better is subjective, cheaper is often irrelevant, but faster is a measurable benefit. A library is a growing organism. Nothing is constant. Make it easy for your customers to tell you what you did well and what was done poorly. Be open, transparent to them. The marketing mix, when I talk about, like what McCarthy talked about, there are four P's of marketing: product, price, promotion, and place. But along with this, in Boomers and Bittner in 1981, they came out with three more P's. So there is a transition has taken place from four P's to seven P's. And all these seven P's, my dear friends, it is very much relevant in the library sector. And that's why in that elliptical shape I have given, it is meant for the service sector domain. When I'm talking about the product, it is the aspect of the marketing mix that deals with the creation, development, and management of the products. Product decisions are important because they directly involve creating products that satisfy customer needs and wants. Introducing new products, modify existing ones, and eliminate those are no longer satisfy customer needs. Now, value, which is a contextual, it value depends on its context and its use by particular users on specific occasions, and cannot be determined in advance. It is also difficult how the value will change over time. The next component is reproducibility and multiplicity. Information is not lost when it is given to others, although it is usefulness for particular purpose. Maybe it is reduced, nor does it diminish when it is consumed. In economic terms, information has a self-multiplicability quality. Information may be easily copied for and by other consumers. Using photocopying, electronic technologies, information can be transformed from one medium to another as when it is scanned into electronic databases or printed out from them. And then is interactivity. Information is a dynamic force for change to the systems within which it operates and must be viewed within an organization as formative, organizing entity rather than as an accumulated stockpile of facts. Then is repackageability. Repackaging is a very, very important context in today's context, especially in the tech savvy area. Information comes in various forms and is expressed in various ways. Several different products may be generated from one database to meet the needs of various audiences. Since new knowledge is created from existing knowledge, it can be difficult to decide when information is original or it is different. Delivery and technology. The use may not only pay for the information but also for the use of the facilities such as retrieval software. Perishability. One characteristic that distinguishes between the goods and the services is perishability. Goods have varying levels of perishability, only have value when they are produced and consumed. Information is essentially non-perishable. Information does not deteriorate over time, but the medium may be. And then the homogeneity. Goods demonstrate a high level homogeneity, but services, due to the personal elements in delivery, are much less consistent. Information products are at the extreme end of the homogeneity spectrum, since each copy is identical to each other copy and to the original. And then inseparability refers to the physical and institutional distance between the originality of the product and the consumer. Goods may pass through several intermediaries between a manufacturer and the purchased by the customer. So, services are inseparable because the producer and the consumer need it, interacted, creating, delivering and consuming the service. So, information is more akin to a good than a service, and it is produced, stored, transported and can exist without being consumed. And then is the tangibility. Refers to the product's physical properties and the excerpts to which it can be seen, felt, heard and fostered or smell. Now, this is a new product development. There are a couple of steps like idea generation, idea screening, concept testing, business analysis, product development, test marketing, commercialization, monitoring and evaluation. So, this is a when you are planning to develop a product for your library to be get marketed, these are the steps you need to follow. Now, these are related to the services, the range of services which you can, you know, do the marketing also, like information surveys, document delivery, interlibrary loan, end user training, market research services, then you have current awareness service, the help desk service, the consultancy service, the financial and business information service, the entertainment service and the computing services. So, all these are the different range of services which are there. These are some of the snapshots of the different end user products, like you have the periodicals and the services which are there on the categories, like the periodicals and the books, like which are the different categories of periodicals. I'm sure all of you are aware of this. And what are the different kinds of categories of books are there? Then you have, other than the books, the other resources like published reports, musical CDs, DVDs and all, and in the books the other fictions and also there. The next component which is related to product is branding. You know, I would urge everybody to read a book by Brand Identity by David Acker, where he talks about in great detail about a particular branding. Creating a branding of a library is a very important, or a product is a very important. Now, what is a brand? A brand is a name, term, sign, symbol or a design or a combination of all of them intended to identify the goods or the services of one seller or group of sellers and to differentiate them from those of the competitors. Brands in the information marketplace, the creation of a corporate identity for their own products or services, the evaluation of branded products and services provided by others in the information marketplace, in the selection of goods that support their activities well end consumers. And the benefits of the brands is your buyer's benefits and it has a seller benefits also. The next P is called pricing. It defines the value obtained in an exchange. So it may be used as a competitive tool. It is one of the marketing mix variable which can be changed quickly with the changing in the environment. When you see there is a, you know, dynamism is taking place in the pricing sector, so you can change the pricing of the product. It plays both economic and psychological role. Economic perspective, it is closely associated with the cost and the profit. Psychological perspective, it may be used as an indicator of quality. And for customers, psychological perspective plays an extremely important role. Now, when you go to our pricing mechanism, so one of the important thing is you need to understand when you are bringing out a product, that's what we have a new product development, that whether your product should be fee or it is free based information products or service. Now, for that, because when you are providing a fee based product, you have to earn a profit from it. And how do you get the profit? It is the price minus the cost on a per unit basis. So you need to do the calculations when you are developing a product, similar kind of a thing. So this is the most important thing when you are getting into the pricing mechanism of any product. Then comes your pricing strategies in the information marketplace. It could be item-based pricing, pay for use, subscription, it could be bundle pricing, it could be a contract pricing, it could be a CD-ROM pricing. Another important component which is on 4Ps is your promotion. Awareness generation about the organization, new or existing products. You have to educate the consumers. It includes advertising, public relations, personal selling, direct marketing. It is one of the two-way communication with the customer that forms the basis for customer relationship. Promotion of services presents specific difficulties because they are intangible. Service advertising and promotion needs tangible clues such as physical facilities, etc. Personal selling plays a very, very vital role for it. Promotional components like advertising, direct marketing, use of mail, telephone, mail shots, leaflets, sales promotions, public relations and publicities, personal selling, sponsorship, large publishing organizations involved in sponsorship of events, support to educational institutions and all. So these are some of the components. I'll show you some of the examples also. So you need to develop a marketing communication strategy for doing a library marketing. So stages in designing a communication strategy is very, very important, like identify the target audience, determine the communication objectives, determine, describe, design the message, select the communication channels, establish promotional budget, decide on promotional mix and the evaluation. Then comes your designing the message. When you are talking about designing a message, please remember one shoe does not fit to all. So you cannot have a one message for every stakeholder. You need to understand who is your audience, who is your customer and what kind of message you should create. It needs a very high level of articulation in creating a message which is impactful. Message content, what messages communicate, message structure, message format and the message source. And next is non-personal communication like, you know, the press, the television, radio, posters, leaflets, web. So what is that channel? You have to get the appropriate, you have to select the appropriate channel to communicate your library. Now, place the delivery mechanisms where the products must be available at the right time at a convenient location. Place is concerned both consumer service delivery points such as small outlets. Distribution outlets that ensures that products are there for their producer or creator to the user to the consumer. Distribution in terms of service, like emphasize on the right service to the right time in a convenient location. Earlier libraries, both academic and public, used to occupy central locations on university campuses. Both with the change in the above situation, branch libraries, mobile technology, electronic delivery mechanisms, etc., change the scenario. And then comes the people. Most services are useful in service delivery, often creating and delivering the product in interaction with the customer. The quality of the interaction between the service and the customer has a major influence on satisfaction. Developing a trust, please remember I'm using and emphasizing the word trust, a rapport with the customer strengthens the service relationship. So when your user, your customer is visiting to your library, please develop a rapport with him. Try to build a trust with him, and that is your strength. Then is the process. Once a customer has experienced a service process for the first time, they start to learn what their contribution to the process should be. In self-service environments, a public access kiosk, the customer is taken through a process by the prompts on the computer screen and then the physical evidence. You, in previous slide, you have seen such a beautiful library with a beautiful color combinations and all. Physical surrounding from service, which a service is delivered. Physical evidence is important in service delivery because it usually the tangible clue that the consumer has bought the quality of the service experience. And libraries and other service industries pay attention to atmosphere, ambience, image, design of the premises. And you need to really look at it when you are coming up with a new library, and which is you have to create it more attractive and all. Then comes your users, customers, stakeholders or clientele. Now, it could be general public. So, it could be professional groups. It could be academic users. It could be business users. It could be information intermediaries. But on the right hand side, what you see here, each one of the categories have a certain different kind of stakeholders. So, you need to understand which category I am serving. So, that is very important. You need to understand these categories. You cannot have a mingle up a library marketing process for each one of them. No, it can't be done like that. So, stakeholders' roles in the information marketplace, that is the producers of the intellectual content, the authors, illustrators, multimedia creation, the controllers of intellectual contents with the reference to quality standards, suitability, publishers establish a corporate brand image and distinguish, ensure that the documents, informations where your library agents, the booksellers, the websites, the online hosts, they all come. So, these are the different kinds of the information marketplace which you need to understand and their roles and responsibilities related to that, which is a very, very important part as far as the stakeholders or users or clientele are concerned. These are something more like library supply agents, you have the redistributors, the users. So, it is a very important thing. You need to understand the different types of stakeholders, their roles and responsibilities, and how they are connected to the information marketplace, which are those touch points that by which they are connected to it. So, that's a very important component which you need to understand that. So, according to, you know, when you are building a customer relationship, there is a very important thing is by Christian Gunrus, is a very renowned person who has talked about service marketing. He says, marketing is to establish, maintain and enhance a relationship with customers and other partners at a profit so that the objectives of the parties involved are met. This is achieved by a mutual exchange and fulfillment of promises. In context to the library and information service, recognize the importance of establishing an appropriate relationship with the customer as is achieved. For example, in public libraries, through an emphasis on customer's care, and in academic libraries through the appointment of subject specialists. So, this is a very, very important thing. In PRC 1999 proposed four different categories of customers based on the relationship. The relationship seekers, the relationship exploiters, the loyal buyers, and the arm's length transaction buyer. So, each one of them are different categories of customers and they have a certain roles which are defined here. So, building customer relationship develops a customer portfolio. So, it is very difficult, important to develop a customer profile alongside the organization's product portfolio. So, then in that you can have a connectivity that what particular customer wants, what kind of product. So, you have to bring in that relationship, that synergy is required in that particular thing and might be viewed as the ultimate realization of the marketing orientations. So, in the marketing planning cycle, you have the marketing audit you have to carry out and analysis. revision of the marketing objectives, because you know time changes, so you have to do a revision strategy on the marketing strategy. So revision or your marketing strategy, revision your marketing programs, the identifications and approval of the marketing budgets, implementation of the marketing plan, and then the you have to bring in the control and evaluation of that. So this is a complete cycle of the marketing planning cycle, which is very, very important into it. So marketing research when you are doing, now this is very fundamental for each one of you. These are the questions, and I call it 5W and 1H: who, what, where, and then when, how, and why. These are some of the fundamental questions I have enumerated here. If you are able to answer each one of them when you are developing your marketing strategy, or you are developing your marketing product or a service, if you answer each one of them, you have developed a foolproof marketing product or a marketing dimension or a marketing dynamic strategy for your organization. This try to address this 5W and 1H in that context. For that, you need to do a lot of data collections. Now, it could be a primary data, it could be a secondary data. Primary data is basically when you conduct observations through survey observations, when you see the movement in the of the stakeholders in your library, and the then or you can conduct a survey. Whereas in secondary data, it is mostly your internal resources and the external resources like accounting records, marketing data bank, sensors, periodical reports which are comes out from the different automation software and all. So that's a very important thing also. Now, when you talk about a secondary data, it that can comes from different sources. That will also facilitate to help you to develop your own marketing strategy also in that context. Now I'll be what we have discussed today. Now I'll be taking into some of the library marketing collaterals, which are extremely important into this concept. Finding the right ways to reach out. Basically, outreach is a very important component, like newsletters, face-to-face, mail, email, telephone, poster signs, word of mouth, websites. Which particular way you are going to reach out to the people? For example, if you're talking about brochure, if you do one, make it a good one. Use targeted brochures, make it eye-catching and very professional. Try a question and answer format and get them to your customers. I'm showing you, this is how a branding is done. Like for example, Brooks Library, they have used a beautiful brochure, and along this brochure, they are also providing a book tag. See, the kind of product, a branded product was developed by them. How beautifully it was designed. Think something creative in these areas. Business cards, make your card a standout ones, but don't be too different. That's also looks very different also. Use your brand or a style and use your degrees. Like for example, these are some of the collateral examples. You can, you know, nowadays you can find that, you know, through online media, such beautiful, you know, the collaterals are developed for your different kinds of cards. It could be business cards, it could be, you know, sending out your wishing somebody on a particular card. It could be different kinds of cards which are inserted for the, you know, as a bookmark. So it can also be a branding can be also be done, or different designs can be also calculated for that. This is a visiting card, very simple, but the kind of color and the, you know, the sharpness created in the fonts and everything, how best it creates a person. So it is from a Carroll University. This is a library card. This is an electronic card, but see how the branding is done on a particular card. And every person, every user feels it proud to carry it in his purse, that I'm carrying such a beautiful card in my, along with my credit cards and other cards, I'm also carrying a library card. So it adds a value to it. Then comes your newsletter. Every library should have a newsletter, but you need to understand what to include. Have a consistent format and regular schedule. A just-in-time email newsletter in interactive, current, inexpensive, cheap, and easy. How about different newsletters for different audiences? So these are some of the glimpses of the and on the shelf. And you don't write it as a newsletter. Like for example, the left hand side, one newsletter talks about on the shelf, which is meant for the children. And this newsletter, you need not to be printed. It could be an electronic newsletter. But beautiful graphics, the design and the layout and the font, that has been used. The different kinds of infographics which have been used. Currently, infographics leads a lot. And then, like for example, the other newsletter, you see how the promotion is taking place. The learn, connect and discover. So, that kind of graffiti they have used in the newsletters and all. Bulletin boards and display cases, easy and cheap. Use a portable easel for a portable bulletin board. Think of a display case as a super board or change all displays frequently. It cannot be stagnant for maybe a month together or not. Keep on changing, keep on bringing something new or the other for more attraction. This is a very interesting, I came across a library display bulletin board, display board and all. How creatively it was done by the students and the faculty and the library professionals, they have created it in the board itself. Another important library marketing collaterals could be giveaways. Use your established color scheme and mascot or slogan. Put on everything, the library's name, address, phone, fax, email address and URL. And another important component is quality, is very important in this context. See, these are the giveaways. Like, you know, a very interesting bookmark drawn with a high-tech pen. And, you know, these are inbuilt developed in the library itself. But the kind of quotation, the kind of language, the kind of font, the kind of graphics which are used, it has to be very, very attractive and all. These are the giveaways. In several libraries with the books which are not used, or maybe the books are no more in use in the library, they give away the free away books. There are several stakeholders, they are looking for such kind of a thing. So, pick me up. It is available for, so you are basically adding value by doing the library marketing. This is the valuation chain you are creating with your customers who are visiting to your library. So your signature can also send. Keep it short, simple and discreet. Included in my signature, like for example, Judy Said, President, Information Bridge. So it also sells, but don't write too much of that. So that also creates a different connotations. Like for this is a very interesting email signature I came across by Jeremy Monde, that how one can also with a picture can have a email signature. So you are, you as a library information science professional, your email signature is also part of your library marketing collateral. That's what I mean to say. Your web page. So content is very king. Set up an internal electronic discussion groups, bulletin boards to facilitate communication within the organizations or with outsiders. Keep it short and simple. Have the links your customers need. And this is a very interesting website, and see the kind of a background which is used, the metadata structure which has been used, and such beautifully it has been created with different kinds of, you know, the color combinations, the transparency in that metadata flail is was used. It is so attractive for the people to coming back again and again and again. And on the other hand, it has to be very user friendly and very interactive also. Your website, make it easy for customers to submit news, sites, suggestions, questions. Try personalized library portals, post photos of the library on the library events. Think like your customer. So you have to put yourself as a customer, and then you try to think that how your website should be. And plan a campaign to make your use aware of the website and all. So this is another library knowledge portal. It was created it has got very, very interactive, lot of resources are there, and very dynamically it was developed and all. And see the placing of the each and every component of the information is also an integral part of your library marketing strategy. So like for example, this is a library posters. It could be another important component. Take time to browse, watch. So these are very nicely designed, some of the library posters. You can display in different, you are conducting an event, you can put up your display with all kinds of logos and contact details and everything. So you are making an avenue for every person to come down and visit to your library. You are welcoming them through your library marketing strategy. Public relations, don't sit on your chair, get out of the library. Deliver items to customer in person, what a department you know little about or which you have the few customers. Visit major locations. Try an open house. Talk to them. Look at your library. Is it inviting? Can the customer find information without help? Can he or she find you will or, I mean, you try to put yourself in the shoes of the customer and then you think on that rate. Then only would be able to build a relationship and build up trust and a personal touch with each and everyone. Greeting friendly, accurate, with a smile in your face because you are into the service industry. Advocacy, no one sees us. Reading reviews, reading manuals, following electronic cataloging, searching for a hard to find article, searching find different databases, going to budget meetings, you know, buttonholing the management to a get a few. So these you have to put together in a package format for a library marketing as an advocacy and all. Professionalism, yes, dress the part, but it is more important to act the part. Continuing education is absolutely imperative. You will have to find it and maybe even for it. Networking, give back to the professions and do something to improve the public's perception of a librarian. Be proud that you are a librarian. You are a professional librarian. What image do we want to become the person who reaches out to others to bring them the answers or perhaps the means to discover those answers for themselves? So changing in the phone booth, it is time to take off your cloak of invisibility, timidity, complacency, modesty and reveal ourselves to the world as we are and can be. So be a visible librarian. If you cannot a visible librarian, you cannot do library marketing. So in the conclusion, unless customers and the collection come together in a way both interesting and meaningful to customers, the library is nothing more than an expensive warehouse. This is a very, very important comment. Marketing is creating an awareness of your value. And this I have taken from a very interesting book. I would request everyone to please read it. It is by Peter Harnan and Altman, that assessing the service quality, satisfying the expectations of the library customers in the today's context. So, my dear professionals, I am looking forward that each one of you will develop, you yourself will develop yourself into visible librarian and you will create your own library marketing strategy for your libraries. Thank you very much.